She's not gonna stay. Neither. Look.
Good morning and welcome to Zohar. We are so glad that you chose to worship with us today, whether you're sitting here in the nice shade on our folding chairs, socially distanced, or if you're at home on your computer or out and about on your iPad or phone. We're just so grateful that you're worshiping with us. We may be separated, but as Pastor reminded us last week, we're many members but one body, so we come together today to worship. It still seems a little strange to be worshiping outdoor every week, but I realized this week that in the story of Zohar, back in 1811, Matt Long wrote that we used to meet before there was a church building under a brush arbor. So I figured that we are not doing a new thing, we are just recreating our history and going back to our roots. So welcome to our outdoor worship. A few announcements. Zohar ladies, there will be a Zoom meeting this afternoon. If you don't know how to Zoom, Lauren, wave, talk to Lauren. We would love to have you on the Zoom meeting. The preschool will be having CPR and first aid training on Saturday, July 25th. So go ahead and sign up for that. The class is $20 a person. And mark your calendars for August 30th. We plan to go out and do one of our service Sundays, so we will look forward to being the body of Zohar out in the community on that day. It just wouldn't seem right today to not at least make mention of the fact of the loss of Congressman John Lewis. I heard a newscast where the man said that he lived out his life trying to be the gospel, especially the Sermon on the Mount. What a wonderful thing to be said about any of us at the end of our life, especially a politician. So let's go ahead and open our worship as Pastor leads us in prayer.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen again.
Amen.
Amen again.
Amen.
That's one for the Father, one for the Son, and one for the Holy Spirit. Don't be bashful about giving Sister Sue Raymond a hand. Our whole purpose is to celebrate each other. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Oh, you can do better than that this morning, church. You ought to be glad to be among the living this morning.
Amen.
You're not laying on your bed of affliction. You didn't take your shoes and put them on your head. You knew your way to Zohar this morning. Amen.
Amen.
And look how pretty. If you have a program, just hold it up. Isn't that a beautiful? Give Sister Tina Howell a hand clap of praise. You might as well get used to it, because I'm going to celebrate you whether you like it or not. Amen.
Amen.
Well, it's that time that those that believe in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ have gathered at his house of worship. Therefore, bow your heads and close your eyes. Lord, open our hearts and our minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Lord, these your people, sanctified, holy, filled with glory, have come to exalt your Son, Jesus Christ, this morning. Lord, we just thank you this morning for every hand that prepared the worship service this morning. In Jesus' matchless name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
verses 10 to 22, and I'll be reading from the New International Version. Jacob left Beersheba and set out for Haran. When he reached a certain place, he stopped for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lay down to sleep. He had a dream in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth with its top reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. There above it stood the Lord, and he said, I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham, the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying. Your descendants will be like the dust of the earth, and you will spread out to the west and to the east, to the north and to the south. All peoples of the earth will be blessed through you and your offspring. I am with you, and I will watch over you wherever you go. And I will bring you back to this land, and I will not leave you until I have done what I promised you. When Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it. He was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? There is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven. Early the next morning, Jacob took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. And he called the place Bethel, though the city used to be called Luz. Then Jacob made a vow, saying, if God will be with me and will watch over me on this journey I am taking, and will give me food to eat and clothes to wear, so that I return safely to my father's household, then the Lord will be my God, and this stone that I have set up as a pillar will be God's house. And of all that you give me, I will give you a tenth. The word of God for the people of Zor.
Thanks be to God.
If you will join me in the responsive reading, you can find the words printed in your bulletin, and you will be reading the bold part. Oh Lord, you have searched me and known me.
You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from afar.
You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways.
Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it all together.
You pursue me behind and before, and lay your hand upon me.
Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain it.
Where shall I go to depart from your spirit?
Where shall I flee from your presence?
If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there.
If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me.
If I say, let only darkness cover me, and the light about me be night.
Even the darkness is not eternal to you. The night is bright as day, for darkness is as light for you.
For it was you who formed my inward parts.
You knit me together in my mother's womb.
I praise you, for you are fearful and wonderful.
Wonderful are your works.
You know me very well.
My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, entered the womb of the depths of the earth.
Your eyes beheld my unformed substance.
And your books were written in the days that were formed for me, every day before they came into being.
How profound to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them.
If I would count them, they are more than the sand. When I awake, I am still with you.
Oh, that you would say to the wicked, O God, that the bloodthirsty would depart from me.
Those who maliciously defile you, who lift themselves up against you.
Do I not hate them that hate you, O Lord? And do I not loathe them that rise up against you?
I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them my enemies.
Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me, and know my thoughts.
And see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting.
this time, we will lift our offering in prayer, knowing that this wonderful God that we serve will bless. Bow your heads. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty, for all that is in heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come of thee. Lord, we beseech you that you continue to do what you've already done to this great church, Zora United Methodist. Bless our offering. Lord, the families of this church have brought in the tithe, brought in the sheaves. So this morning, Lord, I ask you to bless it 30-fold, some 60-fold, some 100-fold. And Lord, we realize that your goodness is not all about money. Lord, where there is favor for your children, I ask you to multiply. But Lord, we do beseech you to provide our storehouses. Give us the means that there is no lack in any storehouse. Bless our tables. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Therefore, we're going to go to his throne, knowing it's not because of how good that we've been, but it's about how merciful our Lord is that our prayers will be answered. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be and obedient church. We have not done your will, Lord. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, Jesus Christ. Forgive us, Lord. Lord, let the love of your forgiveness touch each and every member and friend that's gathered here today. Lord, let your love serve to rejuvenate our organs, to revive our hearts, to regulate our minds, to clear up blurry eyes, and to strengthen limbs that are not as strong as they used to be. Bring wayward sons home. Guide young daughters that they can become virtuous women. Help us to see what you would have us to see. Help us to be what you would want us to be. Oh Lord, I just thank you for a praying mother, Mother Catherine Greer. Lord, in her absence of service with us, I just ask you this morning to gird her up with gladness. I just thank you, Lord, for how she raised me and kept me on the straight and narrow. Oh, Lord, I just thank you this morning for a wonderful wife, Eleanor Greer, a virtuous woman with loving hospitality. Lord, I just thank you for Zora, a church that's looking like what heaven's gonna look like. Lord, I just thank you for our diversity. And Lord, it's nothing that we can get puffed up about, but Lord, it does say something about the hearts of these your people. Lord, you know what they stand in need of? Some dealing with cancer, some dealing with dialysis, some dealing with broken limbs, some dealing with protracted illness. Lord, you just bless some of them that they're up in their years. Lord, some moved away and things changed, but they still belong to Zora United Church, Zora United Methodist Church. Keep us in perfect peace, Lord. We already know that you knew this virus before the virus knew itself. Lord, pierce through the hearts of the state and this nation that wisdom and understanding may prevail, and this great experiment called America go on and see what the end might be. We just thank you, Lord. Lord, I thank you because without C.T. Vivian, John Lewis, and Dr. Martin Luther King, and you know the rest, I wouldn't even be able to stand here this morning, even to lift up your name. But I thank you for a great founding father in John Wesley, who was about your business. Then, Lord, help us to just dig to the roots of this great man. Continue to carry out the vision that he established many years ago. Lord, if it's any heart, if it's any mind, if it's any illness, if it's any burden that I have not mentioned this morning, as the saints of old would say, charge it to my head and not my heart. Teach us, Lord, how to love ye one another and give you all the glory. In Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, the one who died for the remission of our sin, the one who paved the way for reconciliation with our Father. Father Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac. God, we just thank you this morning. In Jesus' name, let all hearts say amen.
Amen.
another hand. Sit out among these beautiful trees. The song said that his kingdom declared his glory and that it's holy. What does holy mean, preacher? Set aside. You've been set aside. The holy church, Zoe, you're holy. You've been set aside for his goodness and his purpose. I know I'm right about it this morning, whether I get an amen or not. I still feel good. I feel good this morning. My wife used to sing a song, and I can't do it, but I feel good, good, good. Amen. I just want to thank you this morning. I hope things are well with you and your families. I thank you for your time, your calls, and your encouragement. I do feel I am among children of God. My information will soon be in the bulletins, and you can call me and set an appointment on Tuesdays to talk about anything that's on your heart. I hope you feel, and I hope you're praying for the steadfast work of the Lord's business here at Zoe. Say amen.
Amen.
We're transparent in how we handle our Lord's business because it belongs to the Lord. Say amen.
Amen.
Not the preacher, not the deacon. This is our Father's business. This morning, in addition to that, I want to give a special, as the young folks would say, a shout out to our Facebook audience, family and friends, for their support. We had 214 viewers last week, and I thank God for each of them. Amen, amen. And our live streaming and Facebook friends, they are supporting us with their love offerings. So we want them to continue to mail. They're offering, if you feel that this church supports your Christian beliefs, please, we need your support. So mail any love offering to 3895 Zoe Church Road. We're in Snellville, Georgia, and our zip code is 30039. Thank you, and we hope that audience continue to grow. Well, there is a word from the Lord this morning. I like to use, when I can, our United Methodist lectionary, unless the Holy Spirit says otherwise. And this week, our lessons tie into last week, which was many members, one body. As Methodists, we are a connectional body. As a church, our strength is in our connection and our diversity of our gifts. So we just thank the Lord for each of you. This week's message is Creation Waits. Therefore, nothing shall separate us from the love of God. In that fitting, we are here sitting under these beautiful trees on this beautiful landscape. And we can just look around at the wonder of our Lord. He's a mighty God. Our mission will continue to be celebrating our members and all of their gifts. How many know that you all have a gift? Some of us got one, two, three, four, five, but we all were endowed with a gift by our Lord. And you're not going to be happy in this world until you're fully expressing that gift. Creation waits. Think about that. Creation waits. Therefore, nothing shall separate us from the love of God. Bow your heads in prayer. Lord, allow me to decrease so that your word can increase, so that it can be planted in the fertile soil of these your people. Lord, you already know all about them. You know their hearts, you know their minds, and you know their souls. Lord, infuse the Holy Spirit this morning that they are changed, that they become new creatures in Christ, that they recognize each and every day is new. Lord, I just thank you. I just thank you for this message, and I just ask the Holy Spirit to preach this message this morning. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Those that have their Bibles, you can turn to Romans. Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8 as a focal text. I'm going to read from the King James Version starting at verse 19. And out of respect and honor for God, just wave your hand. Just wave your hand. Just let the Lord know that you respect him, that we're not going to stand up this morning. Some of us are a little too young to stand up, but I thank you, Lord, for all that you've done. These are the words from Paul. You know Paul, St. Paul, that great evangelist. He wrote most of the New Testament. Men and women still are dividing and discerning the powerful words that he left behind. He penned these words to the Romans for the earnest expectation of the creature waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willing, but by reason of him who has subbed the same in hope. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bonds of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together unto now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruit. Say first fruit. Of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our bodies. For we are saved by hope. But hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why doeth he yet hope for? But if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. Verse 35 says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or perils or sword? Verse 37 says, nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word. It says, the creature wait for the manifestation of the sons of God. That's you and me. We are the sons of God. Because the creatures and creation, because of Adam's fall, was likewise subjected to vanity. Not willingly, but by reason of him who subjected the same in hope, because the creature itself also shall be delivered. Church, the world, God's creation is waiting on us. We don't have an excuse any longer. We got to get up off our do nothing and reach out to this world. This sin-sick world that's dying for lack of vision. Well, preacher, I'm not perfect, and how can I do that? I'm glad you asked. Because as Christians, we have to understand the difference biblically and a Western perspective of perfect. See, in the world, perfect is kind of conforming absolutely to an ideal type. But when it comes to your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, perfect is entire, complete, wanting nothing. And above all, he looks at our hearts, which is why in chapter 8, verse 1, Paul said, There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. So the now is Jesus. I can't do it on my own. See, John Wesley said it this way. He talked about Christian perfection, which is the walk in life that you all are on. And Paul has helped us to understand that you're justified, young lady, that you're justified, that you can stop trying to prove who you are. See, that's vanity. That's vanity, vanity, vanity. God is looking at our heart, and Jesus has purified our heart. You know, white folks got to get over being guilty about the past, and black folks got to get to the present and do what this great liberty affords us to do. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
See, there is no condemnation in Jesus Christ for the law of the Spirit. Well, what is that, preacher? Galatians, also Paul, give us a roadmap of how we can walk in the Spirit. You heard it before. It's called the fruits of the Spirit. That's what I expect around here. I expect the fruits of the Spirit. See, if you're upset and if you're mad, then leave that at home when you come to church. You ought to do like Paul said, but the fruits of the Spirit is love, joy. Did you smile at anybody this morning? Did you encourage anybody? You may not have felt like it. Your body could be wrecking in pain, but he requires joy. Did you stir anything up, or did you have peace this morning? You ought to be able to come to church and feel like you are cleansed, and you came one way, but you leave another way because there was peace among the saints. Amen. Young folks, I want to teach you a word that my mother and father knew about, and your mother and father. So there's a word called long-suffering. Say amen.
Amen.
You see, America is great. America is about life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness. But you got to be persistent. You got to be steadfast. You can't give up on this thing. Some of our loved ones have dealt with protracted medical conditions. Some of our loved ones have cared for other loved ones, and it calls for long suffering. That's not a bad word. That just means that in spite of trials and tribulations, we're able to go on anyway and see what the end might be. Oh, I know I'm right about it. Then one of the fruits is gentleness. Husband, wives, don't forget about gentleness when you're dealing with your spouse. Be gentle with each other.
Be kind to each other. Goodness and faith and meekness and temperance. Paul said, against such there is no law. Against such there is no law. What does that mean? Zoar is unstoppable. Zoar is invisible. Zoar invincible. Zoar is an overcomer. Why? Because we practice love and joy, peace, long suffering, gentleness. We reach out to the community. There's outreach. There is ministry going on at this great church. We're saying about the sick and the shut in. We care about each other. Therefore, meekness. I like to say meekness doesn't mean weakness. Say amen.
Amen.
Oh, don't you get it twisted. Zoe ain't weak now. But we meek. It just means that we have a heart for humility. We have a heart for God. That we chose to practice the fruits of the Spirit. And we know how to treat each other. See, if you can't get a smile nowhere else, you come to Zoe. You can get a smile. And if it wasn't for the virus, we'll hug you too. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So what I'm saying is Paul wanted us to understand that this walk of life with the Spirit of the life of Jesus Christ have made me free from the law of sin and death. That's not made. That's not a might. That's done. We're free. We're free. We're free because Jesus Christ ushered in grace and mercy. Oh, grace and mercy. Oh, grace and mercy. I want to ask you, church, this morning, to think back over your life. Did you get what you truly deserve? Oh, it was his grace and mercy. Oh, if he had judged us, where would we be? We'd have been struck down. Because none of us, all of us have fallen short of his grace and mercy. But thank God we got a Savior. Oh, we have Jesus Christ who died on Calvary's cross that we can be saved. He talked about that we have to get rid of this cardinal mind. My prayer to the nation, this great America, we forget about our cardinal mind. It's time for us to fall back on the principles of our founding fathers who founded it on this Judeo-Christian religion, who believed in God. Oh, we wish, we long for the day when we had men who served us, with dignity. And like the preacher, realize that it's an honor to serve Americans. It's an honor to serve Zoar United Methodist Church. How can we do this? We have to get rid of our cardinal mind. For to be cardinal minded is death. But to be spiritual minded is life and peace, because the cardinal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subjected to the law of God. Neither indeed can it be. So you see, man was placed on earth as a steward of his wonderful creation. And because of the fall of man, even animals. Isaiah said it this way. He said, one day the lamb's going to lay down with the lion and the little boy's going to play over the top of the snake. That's a hole, and nothing is going to happen because it's on us. This community church is waiting on us to continue our Father's business. Oh, that's the manifestation. You can do it. You all you need to be, because Christ died for each one of us. Therefore, we are the sons of God. Well, preacher, I can't move like I used to. Verse 26 says this: Holy Spirit. Somebody say Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit. Say it again. The Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
this Holy Spirit. Well, if there's a Holy Spirit, there got to be an evil spirit. Say amen.
Amen.
Oh, but we seek this Holy Spirit. It says, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself making intercession for us with groaning which we cannot utter. And he that search the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercessions for the saints according to the will of God. And we know, saying
we know,
and we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them who are called according to your own will. You better not say amen on that. Call according to the deacon's will. That don't sound right. Call according to the pastor. No, it's called according to his purpose.
Amen.
His purpose, which is why I beseech you, members and friends, that you pray the Holy Spirit. Pray the Holy Spirit and ask the Holy Spirit, what would he have us to do to get to the next level at Zoar? Oh, that I know I'm right about it. Because there are going to be some ups and there are going to be some downs. I just thank God for he sustained this church through this virus. But I got news for the virus. Our God is bigger. Oh, I got news for this virus. Our God is back. Our God is above. Our God knew all things about this virus before it even knew itself. And our God is going to see us through it. How do you know that, preacher? Well, the Bible tells me, who shall separate us from the Lord of Christ? Shall tribulations? Or distress, persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or pearls, or sword? No, Paul said none of that. If we're practicing love and gentleness and peace and temperance and kindness, nothing can stop us. You see, he said, nay, in all things we are more than conquerors. Oh, I like to see fights every now and then, but we're more than conquerors. See, that's, you know, bruises are getting in there, but we're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors. You know, love is the only thing that never fails. That's why we have life and have it more abundantly. Because nobody could love us more than our beloved Jesus. He didn't do a thing. He was perfect in the worldly sense and in the godly sense. He didn't have to go up on that cross, but he did to make us more than conquerors. For I am fully persuaded that neither death, he defeated it. Nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height or depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Well, so what does the Lord want us to do? Well, I'll tell you, we must realize that the believers, as believers, we're set free. Forget about your past. Forget about yesterday. We learn from our mistakes and we move on down the King's Highway. Everybody is the best they can be today. Now tomorrow you ought to do better. Say amen.
Amen.
But be the best that you can be today. This I tell you, Zoar, this is the love of your Savior, Jesus Christ, that this creation, this nation, this state, this community, this neighborhood is waiting on our families with this hope, this hope that Zoar is going to march into the next decade, march into the future with this hope. We're going to lift the burdens of our members by praying for some need jobs and some need healing and some need companionship and some need restorations of their family. With this hope, we're going to reopen our preschool. With this hope, we're going to overcome the coronavirus 19. With this hope, one day we're going to march back into our sanctuary. With this hope, we're going to heal our sick. With this hope, we're going to march on to Christian perfection, realizing that we're justified by Jesus Christ, that you've been sanctified and set aside and are holy. And when we exercise the fruits of the Spirit, then we're glorified with His Son. What is Christian perfection, preacher?
Well, it's a gradual march or a dramatic march. It's us as Christians. You see, the beauty of us being Methodist. If a Methodist, say amen.
Amen.
Oh, don't discount the wonder of this great Methodist tradition.
Amen.
It is the most powerful denomination in the nation.
Yes.
You made the right decision.
Yes.
You made the right decision, and all we have to do is get in here and get back to the root.
Amen.
Not what they wrote 10 years ago. I'm talking about in the 1700s and 1800s, how they did it then.
Amen.
Even back then, John Wesley was fighting against slavery because he said, now wait a minute, how can this be? We got men that are serving us today that are not standing up.
Amen.
We're going to stand up.
Yes.
We're going to stand up and serve the Lord. We're going to stand up and help each other. We're going to stand up and do what the Lord would have us to do. God bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and His Holy Spirit. At this time, the doors of the church are open. Well, don't worry about this old bald head or this old stomach. You're not. You're giving the Lord your heart. You're giving me your hand. But we need good members. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We need members that are willing to come, realizing that we're just ordinary people doing extraordinary things for the Lord. We need members that realize that we're many members, but we connect as one body. We need members that realize that my gift may not be your gift,
amen,
but your gift is precious unto the Lord. We need young people that are willing to take the banner and run this race.
Yeah.
Run this race for joy, that we can see what the end might be. Would there be one? God bless you. At this time, I want to call up my sugar lump. Somebody say amen. So, as long as the vine go around the stump, she'll always be my sugar lump. I just love this woman. I love her. I loved her for 25 years. She's precious in my sight. So I asked for help this morning. You see, I heard an old story. How a Savior came from glory. How He gave His life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. You may know it. I heard about His groaning, of His precious blood atoning. Then I repented of my sins and won the victory. Church, victory in Jesus. God bless you.
I heard an old story, how Savior came from glory. I gave His life on Calvary to repented of my sins and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He stopped me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me and I knew him, and all my love is due him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about his healing, of his cleansing power revealing. I made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see.
Celebrate this great morning, and God has allowed us to another beautiful, beautiful day with just a little wind. And I thank each and every one. Give yourselves a hand clap of praise. Thank you all for coming. I do want to add for the young people, look for a Zoom invite. The young people are having a meeting Tuesday at 7 p.m. Tuesday at 7 p.m. Is there anything else that needs to come before this body before we... Sister Tina, everything is fine? Okay. Is there anybody else that have any announcement or anything that needs to come before this body before we close? Therefore, let's take a few deep breaths in. When you breathe in, say grace.
Great.
When you breathe out, say mercy.
Mercy.
Breathe in, grace.
Grace.
Breathe out, mercy. One more time. Breathe in, grace. And breathe out, mercy. Now I'm going to ask you to stand. Amen.
Amen.
Repeat these words after me, which can be found in 1 Timothy 1:17. Now to the King Eternal.
Now to the King Eternal.
Immortal.
Immortal.
Invisible.
Invisible.
The only wise God.
The only wise God.
Beyond in glory.
Beyond in glory.
Forever and ever.
Forever and ever.
Trifold, amen.
Amen.
Where you stay, I'll stay. How you doing this morning?
Morning, morning, morning.
Morning, morning.
Really?